Hi, good morning, Maggie.
Woo. Good morning.
Morning. So you just had rehearsal last night for I Pagliacci.
Yes.
Yeah. And all that that entails. Have you had time to do a little body warm-up today, or?
I haven't done a ton of body warming up, no.
Well, take just a moment, maybe do a little shoulder roll thing. How's your neck and back and shoulders been lately?
Pretty good, given all the rehearsing.
Yeah? Alright, maybe put your hands up and just do a little wake up there. Oh, that feels so good. Okay, how about your jaw? How's that been going?
It's been going okay.
Yeah?
some clenching recently with everything going on, but I'm trying to be aware of that and counteract it.
Yeah, I mean, it's just, you know, you don't want to get all in a state about it, but just be mindful. You know, it's like, do I need to hold my jaw like this? You know, just, I make it a little game, right? You know, it's just like, I bet I could use 5% less effort in my jaw. Mm-hmm. You know, how about 5 more? And then you realize, I don't need to do any of that stuff. Yeah. Okay. All right, why don't you grab a straw there? Let's start with that. And I was just thinking, that's really soft. Just a triad. Through your straw, let's do an A vowel.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. Can you make sure there's not any leak around your mouth?
Yes.
It almost sounds kazoo-like, yeah. Yeah, I mean, the other is a different kind of SOBC. Yeah. Seems to be going all right. Maybe put your hand at the end so you can feel the flow of air coming through the straw. Stuff lately?
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah, it's good, you know, especially like initial warm up and cool down.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it just really like very gentle. Cool. We'll keep that handy. We'll probably bring it back out in a little while.
Okay.
I was thinking, how about
sure.
uneasy knees. I felt like you might be just going back a little bit. And,
okay.
Or, you know, and I was just thinking just a little lower back release that you might get from the release in your knees.
Oh, knees. I thought you said ease.
No, knees.
Okay.
Knees. Yeah, yeah, because I just felt like you were a little here, and I was thinking, you know, if you just, your knees were just that little bit softer, that you might get a little more lower back release.
Okay.
Warms up quick since you're doing a lot of
rehearsal. Yeah, pretty quickly.
Yeah. Yeah. That, you know, I mean, how late were you guys rehearsing last night?
Not too late. We got out at 8:30.
Yeah, because you sent me that email and I thought, okay, well, she's home soon.
it's a short opera.
Right. Let's head back up. Allowing the vibrato to be there. Slightly more open than the ooh. Yeah, try again.
Okay.
the lower. So when you're doing you know, you might just feel a little more of the lateral kind of stretch.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, this is that falsial pillar area, you know, and just thinking a little more of that going on. Try again.
Okay.
It's not as wide out as, you know, when we were a fourth or so higher. Dosher used to talk about, you know, the lower you got, you know, the shallower the cup,
mm-hmm.
you know. I think she was stealing that from Coffin, too, but okay, cool. So, mid-range seems to be kind of fluid, kind of happy. Okay. How's about variation, you know, on this pattern? How about just kind of skimming the stone across the pond, yeah?
Okay.
Oh, cool. Just level gaze, not too high. Sing, but not under sing.
Okay.
Yeah. Too much there. I think, you know, maybe thinking a little more of the, you know, the rib cage buoyancy and let this take care of itself. I mean, if a hand there helps you just kind of, all right, yep, that's not overworking.
Okay.
Another way to think of that is think about the release of each one so that it's not tha, tha, but instead of tha, 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 or, yeah.
Okay.
Not too soft, not too loud. Good, doing all right. See if you can find a way that the top note is not drastically louder than the others.
Sure.
Yeah, I mean, just lilting, graceful. Portray tenderness, and I mean the aria is all about saying I love you without saying I love you, you know. So how do you do that, thinking that affect as you do this?
Okay.
Wow, that's really nice. More, I love you. Then we go, oh, wow, gosh, how nice to hear finally, you know? Yeah, one or two more. Do you feel the need to do the whole thing fluidly, or do you think we should go on?
Yeah, I think it would be good to do that.
Okay, so let's do the whole thing now. Put a gesture with it, you know, or you can walk around the room, but just some nice, big, long thought of the phrase rather than the fact that the pattern is hippy-skippy.
Okay, I'm just on.
There's a target, especially since we put the A on the lower part of each little pattern. You know, it's like, and focus, and focus, and focus. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, cool. I felt like I was kind of clunking down.
Yeah. Well, and then, you know, then you take the A out and like, okay, yep, I can still retain that. You know, you could do it, you know, something like that would do the same thing.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, cool. Okay, I got a couple different ideas here. I'll put it in your court as to which one you feel like you need. So I thought of a couple things. We could do that one. Or we could do something like, you know, putting your mask on and using a raspberry and like a kind of a little triplet thing. Or we could do a so some kind of faster work, maybe.
I think that last one.
Okay, with the thirds up and then the triplets down.
Yeah, could I hear that again?
Yeah, so doing something like, hey, and then we could do like a.
Okay.
Triplets
so
on the way down.
The seconds on the way up.
Yeah, so.
Triplets. Okay.
And then triplet, triplet, triplet.
Yeah,
yeah,
I think
okay, because that relates to the run at the end of the aria, especially. So, hey, on the way up, and then, put an A at the bottom again.
Okay.
Okay.
It was A, and then on the way up.
Hey, saying make a vibrato happen, but allow the flow to be there, and if the vibrato is there, great.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so now let's sing the pattern.
Okay.
Yeah, it's my thing, Maggie, is that you get two open on the first ah.
Okay.
And you get a little down there.
Okay. Just on the way up.
Just do it on the way up on the standing wave thing. Then we'll take a pause and then sing it. Yeah.
Okay.
Say, don't peep. heavier to me, and the like your palatal lift and so on is better when you sing out that little bit more, and the vibrato is there. I think the flow is consistent that way.
Mm-hmm.
Than to do it, you know, a little less.
Sure.
Yeah. Does that make sense to you?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So now, what if we sped it up, make it more of a florid thing? Turn this up so you can hear. I don't think we need to do that now.
Okay. Should they be connected or separate?
I mean, I would say, like...
Okay.
Just go from one to the other.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Right, okay, so it's the flow while you're doing the turn is what I'm really after. Okay, so now let's try it without the straw. Okay. Put an emotion with it, like it's a little caress, you know, it's a little vocal way of expressing tenderness. The easier your flow is as you do the turn.
Okay.
Sure, yeah. I play around with that because there are several times where you have to, like, libero. You gotta do little turns.
Mm-hmm.
Let's do one more thing. I just wanted to, do just one or two little messa di voce things, and then relating it to the start of the aria. So yeah, straw down, I think. Feeling okay though?
Yeah, feeling good.
So how about a messa di voce on E? It's a nice, long, slow crescendo, decrescendo.
Okay.
Feel. a couple times just to feel, all right, how precise could that onset be? Because if you start well, the whole thing goes well.
Okay.
So that's my experience with the Messa di Voce. It's all about, do I get a good start? Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Just do this for body.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
Okay? Yeah, just very, very easy. How clean and easy can that be?
Okay.
Cool. Uh-huh. All right, so now do the Messa di Voce. Could you be thinking the vibrato there from the very beginning?
Mm-hmm.
I know I've said this several times today, but I think it's just it's an indicator that the flow is really good at the start.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. How about A? Sure that flow is right there. Good. Okay, now do Prendi, like you got there at the beginning. Sure. Okay, do it, just the Messa di Voce thing.
Okay.
Yeah, just the E.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah, so you started with the vowel a little more closed to do the pianissimo. So see if you can do that when you do thinking, okay, it's really, I'm starting more A, and I go to E to do the crescendo.
Okay.
Yeah, how's it feeling breath-wise?
Feels pretty good, I think.
Yeah. Maybe put a tiny bit of B in your P.
Okay.
That might make it a little easier to get started.
Okay.
Yeah.
Andy.
Wow.
That helped a lot.
Wow. Yeah. Yes. You know, because the voiced consonant has a little less pressure. Yeah. That was really, really good. Can you Disney Princess a little bit more on the shimmery descent?
Mm-hmm.
You know, try one more time.
Okay.
Prendi. Yeah, it's better Italian, honestly. Prendi.
Mm-hmm.
Feel like singing the aria now?
Sure.
Yeah? You feel like you're warmed up?
Good? Yeah, I feel good.
So, with regards to Sodi, are you thinking this is a starter, or are you thinking...
I wasn't really sure, and I wanted to ask for your thoughts on that.
Yeah.
Because I think it is a very strong piece to start with, but I also think they probably would ask for it anyway.
Right, because it's exposed and it's slow. It's bel canto line. Yeah, it's they're gonna pick it no matter what.
So, I don't know. I kind of had been toying around with the idea of starting with the Purcell.
The
Blessed Virgin's expostulation.
Okay.
I don't know what you think about that.
Yeah, Yeah, it's nice. It's a lot of moods. I mean, it's got florid stuff. It's got, you know, all sorts of emotive. It's like an aria in a lot of ways. Yeah, I think that would be cool.
Yeah, and I'm also sort of hoping they won't pick the Bach, so
It's like, okay, check, we've done Baroque, yeah.
Yeah.
And then they're probably going to go, who's this Gartman, you know?
Yeah.
And they'll probably want to hear one of those. You know, they'll go, well, but they've already heard English, so they might want to hear French. Yeah, they might want to hear French, or they might want to hear one of the Lieder, one of the Mahler maybe, or Wolf.
Yeah, I hope they ask for it because of the leader competition.
Yes, exactly. Well, I think if you checked that you wanted to do that. Or
I
no, they do it
they do
anyway.
it
They do
automatically,
it
right?
automatically.
Yeah.
Yeah, they do it automatically. Yeah. Well, yeah, I mean, you can expect to sing all four languages for sure. So, yeah, if you led with Purcell, that probably they're going to go, okay, well, we've gotten English out of the way. They probably want to hear this, one of the French, and one of the German, and then whatever time they have left.
Yeah.
So, all right, let's do it.
Okay.
Give me the whole intro. I practiced it last night. How you feel about expressing how you feel about Nemorino?
I don't think that was my best acting performance.
Yeah.
I was a little bit in the weeds thinking about intonation that time.
Yeah.
But, you know, pretty good.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. No, I think the especially, you know, like the flights up, you know, you know, some of those are really going nicely. And,
thank you.
You know, the very soaring kind of sound that really shows you to good effect is going well.
Thank you.
Yeah. I would say be mindful of the releases, you know, because sometimes if the breath pressure is a little high, we hear just a little, you know, you know, we hear a little bit of that going at the release instead of release to just letting air come in. So could we start maybe just right at Prendi and thinking that idea? Gets us into such trouble. I'm so proud of it. But you are capable of doing it so well.
Thank you.
And that really fits the vibe of the aria too. Cool. Let's look at getting into the so maybe we start at start there.
Okay.
Yeah. Those are, you know, because that's all you're really doing is ornamenting. You're just ornamenting that with a, and then there's a little half step thing, and another little half step thing, and another little half step thing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So tune into your music theory brain there for a moment.
Yes.
Which you're very good at. Okay, could we go from this?
Oh,
don't lose the whole motivation, right? Because what does all this stuff mean?
It's really like, oh wow, these are great qualities. You're so earnest, honest. And I think that one is less to him and more to herself.
Yeah, because you've been saying, you know, saggio, amoroso, onesto, and you, wise and honest, well, wise is not something, you know, we typically think of Nemorino being, but I mean, you know, she's trying to play nicey, and she's realizing that there's really been this nice guy here all along,
mm-hmm.
who just, he just loves her for who she is, you know, which is not a bad thing in the world. I was talking with another student the other night. We were kind of talking life stuff, and we were talking about, you know, well, have you played the Mirror of Erised game, where what would you see if you looked at this mirror and it was showing you your heart's most deepest, desperate desire? And waited for a second. And I said, I mean, for all of us, it's to be loved and to love.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you know, to love and to be loved for exactly who we are, not who we put on, but who we really are. And then her dog was in her lap, and I said, which is why we have dogs. but truly, you know, she's seeing, here's this guy who he's not full of himself like Belcore is. He's this simple, sweet man who loves her.
Mm-hmm.
And could she do any better than that? And so it's finally kind of coming through to her. So, let's sing it one more time, reflecting upon all that.
Sure.
Okay, so maybe starting at Quido.
Okay.
Joseph is just this sweet, sweet guy.
Yeah, there's some parallels.
Yeah, he's just this sweet, sweet guy who loves you, you know?
Yeah.
So why not, you know, use what you internally know?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you want to do the final cadenza?
Yes. I want to know what your thoughts are on breath there. I am breathing before it, so I'm doing non-non-ta-da-i, breath.
Yes.
I feel like that's not working real well for me.
Okay.
But I also struggle to get through the whole thing if I don't breathe.
Yeah, because you either gotta go really fast.
Because I want to hang out for a second on the first, well, the C, but also the first note of sa ra ra da 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 before.
Yeah. Okay, well, let me hear it without the breath.
Okay.
Let's see. Open there, yeah, it's like, yeah, swimming.
It's getting away from me.
yeah. Okay, so right on there.
Okay.
Better. Yeah. Do you feel like you're having a what? carefully about intonation?
I don't know that I was thinking about it as much on this one,
mm-hmm.
because it's not chromatic.
You know, I would say maybe don't slow down too much. So. Maybe wait to slow down towards the end.
Okay.
And see, that'll help you pacing breath-wise.
Mm-hmm.
One more time. Okay, just for practice purposes. Let's put some yas in there just to kind of give you some landmarks.
Okay.
Thing or is it a breath thing?
It's a breath thing.
It's a breath thing. Okay, what I'm observing is when you're starting, I feel like you're holding air back right there.
Yeah, I feel like I need to keep it all in the tank for what's coming next.
Yeah, well, what if instead of running from the thing that scares you, run towards it?
Okay.
Okay. So, rather than like trying to drive with a brake on there, actually go ahead and use it and see what happens. I mean,
okay.
If you run out, we go, okay, well, that wasn't it.
Okay.
Practice-wise.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay. It's going well. The C's shining nice.
Thank
you.
Know?
Yeah.
C feels good.
Yeah. Want to warm down just a smidge?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's go back to the thing with the straw. Allow the airflow to be there. If the vibrato emerges, great. Let's do hum and chew.
Okay.
feel compared to, what, 45 minutes ago or so?
I feel pretty, like, I feel like my stamina is good.
Yeah.
I don't really feel a huge difference in the way it actually feels.
Yeah, okay. How's your speaking voice feel?
My speaking voice feels pretty warm.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, you know, just continuing to use the flow we were talking about in the exercises and in the rep, you know, just make that a part of your speech as well. I mean, we've had that conversation many times before, but it bears repeating because it is one voice. And I think the aria is going really well, you know, just I think those two runs, really,
mm-hmm.
you know, the intonation on the middle one, just having those landmarks. Like,